Roof maintenance on industrial sites is required regularly to protect the building and its contents from severe weather conditions. External access equipment, such as ladders, can facilitate routine maintenance and repairs, minimizing operational disruptions. However, these ladders must be equipped with fall arrest systems to ensure worker safety. Fall Protect Hungary has supplied a 10-meter, 32-foot of Securail Pro vertical rail lifeline that has been installed permanently on the rungs of an existing ladder at an industrial site in Budapest. This system complies with EN 353-1 2018, ANSI 14.3, and OSHA 1910.26 subpart D. The main components of a 10-meter, 32-foot system are a pre-existing ladder fixed on the wall or host structure, one extension RHF-524 to be mounted on ladder to access the roof with junction RHF-506 included, 10 meters, 32 feet, of Securail Pro rail RHF-553. Junctions RHF-506 are required for rail lengths over 3 meters, 9.8 feet. One bottom-tilting end stop RHF-522 with junction RHF-506 included. Six fixing assembly RHF-521 on ladder rungs. One trolley Granvia 4 with shock absorber RHF-518. The extension RHF-524 is not to be considered as a protection against falls from height, so an anchor point should be provided on the roof at the exit of the ladder that allows the user to attach himself with a lanyard fitted with an energy absorber. An identification plate must be installed near the entry of the system in the area where users attach themselves. This is a mandatory requirement. The tools required for the installation are the following: a flat key set, an Allen key set, a screwdriver drill, a set of HSS drills, diameter 8mm, 0.31 inches, a drilling template, RHF-512, a metal file. To allow the rail temperature expansion, a gap of 3mm, 0.12 inches, should be maintained between the two rails. The four M6 bolts are to be tightened with a torque of 7 newton meters, 6 pound feet. When drilling on site is needed, it should be done using the RHF-512 drilling template. Drill the two rails RHF-553 four times with an 8 millimeter, 0.31 inches drill bit. Fix the four M6 bolts that connect the rails through the junction of RHF-506. Ensure that the tightening torque is 7 newton meter, 6 pound feet, and include the rubber piece to allow for expansion due to temperature changes. A tilting end stop is installed at each end of the track, including a junction RHF-506 and a keyed plate RHF-519. The keyed plate must be on the right side. Tighten the four bolts at 7 newton meter, 6 pound feet torque and ensure the rubber piece is in place. The transfer from a ladder to the roof is a situation during which workers are exposed to the risk of falling. To avoid this, Fall Protect recommends the installation of a curved rail, RHF-524, that enables the end user to reach the roof while remaining attached to the rail. The extension is equipped with a tilting end stop and a keyed plate. It is clamped on three ladder rungs and connected to the rail by a junction RHF-506. First, install the extension RHF-524 and then proceed to install the rail downwards. This will allow for adjustments to be made to the length of the straight rail before installation. Ensure the maximal difference between fixations RHF-521 is 2.8 meters, 9.2 feet, with the rail displaced to the right of the center for optimal exit capability. To properly tighten the M10, it is recommended to use a torque of 30 to 40 newton meters, 22 to 29 pound feet. Be careful with the ladder rung to not deform it. Finally, make sure the rail is fully aligned vertically for maximum safety and functionality. Install the anchor point near the exit of the curve, either on the roof or on a nearby structure. The anchor point enables users to attach themselves to a lanyard fitted with an energy absorber before disconnecting from the fall arrest system. For easy tracking and maintenance, mark the anchor point with a unique number using a Fall Protect aluminium seal. The RHF518 Fall Arrest Trolley Granvia 4 enables the user to attach themselves to the rail system, and its rollers provide smooth movement while climbing up or down. With a mechanical coupling system, it ensures safe movement and instant lock in case of a fall. To ensure proper functioning and safety, it is necessary to test all functions of the Granvia 4 trolley. When inserting the trolley onto the rail, ensure that the arrow is pointing upwards. The tilting end stop should tilt when the trolley is inserted onto the system. The fall arrest trolley should be equipped with an energy absorber that complies with EN355 or ANSI Z359.13. It should be attached to the harness by a carabiner that is fixed directly to the sternal anchorage point of the harness without any intermediate piece. Visually inspect and check the alignment and conditions. Verify the correct functioning of the Granvia 4 trolley on the Securail Pro by performing a test along the entire length, ensuring that the trolley runs smoothly on the rail, and test all entry and exit points. In the event of a fall, the maximum effort transmitted to the host structure should be 6 kilonewtons, 1,350 pound-feet, divided among the number of brackets. The rail will not deform at all. Before detaching from the anchoring device, the user must ensure they are in a safe situation. It is mandatory to install the ID plate near the anchor device in the zone where users attach themselves. The plate is generated by the Fall Protect Assistant web portal and can be printed on a printer using the weather-resistant sticker provided by Fall Protect. The commissioning date must be visible on the plate. Additionally, make sure to label the system with the durable Fall Protect aluminium seal. Before using the system, the user must locate the ID plate and follow the instructions on the board. The plate has a QR code that provides access to the Fall Protect web portal where all data regarding the installation is registered, such as the user manual and inspection log.